All right, this was max effort upper body, and I did floor presses here. It's kind of a weird movement because I have to lay my head on top of something, which really sucks. It looks like I touched my chest there. These are tempo dumbbell presses on the incline, but it looks like I touched my chest there, but still it's super hard for me to do floor presses. I'm a lot stronger than I used to be because I think my arms got stronger, but it's way harder than a regular bench because I think you just lose that momentum from a regular bench. So very good exercise for me. I'm not strong at it. I'm weak at it compared to my bench, but my bench is, you know, 70 pounds more, but it's going to be good for me to build my arms up. So I'll cycle back through that. Then I hit my weaknesses here afterwards. Arms, the incline press isn't really a weakness, but I just want to hit something with the dumbbells for tempo rep, build some muscle. My shoulders definitely respond the most to my pressing, so I got to work my arms. So I'm doing like the Dave Tate press, tricep extension, but on an incline. I don't know if that's how they normally do it or not, but you definitely feel it really good in your tricep doing this exercise like this. So been fine-tuning and honing this program in. Learning a lot. You know, you're gonna take a few steps back to take this few steps forward. Here I'm doing some dumbbell curls. Working those arms. Arms. That's what I'm gonna be hitting on max effort upper body days. Because my shoulders are strong. So I'm just carrying the bench press. So arms is what I need. But you're gonna have to do exercises that you're not excelling at. You know, like I'm way better at bench press than I am at dead presses or floor presses, which I've done. But that's how my arms are gonna get stronger. And that's how my bench is gonna get stronger. So, you know, the conjugate's really making sense to me. I don't know if I said that before, but I got certified in the conjugate system. And it definitely makes sense. But once you put it into practice, you know, you gotta overcome some things. And one thing I will say is the speed work is hard for me. It doesn't seem effective. But I'm trying to get it in my head that it's for technique. I think on the lifts I'm really fast at, you know, on bench press and deadlift I'm naturally fast at, and squat I'm not, so it's hard to see improvement though. That's one thing, you know, it's hard to see improvement, so I'm gonna have to maybe talk to more people. I do know Greg Panora said he didn't do speed work. I talked to Travis Osborne, he said that he does repetition work instead of speed work. And a lot of people veer away from the max effort on the singles as well, which I could see why, because like when I did floor presses, I was like, man, I don't know how to do this. My coordination's not very good. And I thought maybe it's a better idea to just do some reps. Although I am glad that I went up to 405, because I got it. And but it just felt awkward, and it was kind of even scary to a degree because I was like, man, I don't know if I'm going to get this, you know? Last time I did floor presses, which was years and years and years ago, I just remember being not strong at all at them. Like, I was shocked. I was like, is it really that much harder than a bench press to do a floor press? It's a good way to build the triceps, you know? And for me, yeah, if I miss a bench, it's halfway up, so I need to work on all that top end stuff. So a lot of what I'll be doing. The secret is, there is no secret. The real learning is in the doing. And if you don't know what to do, go to my website, www.davenportbarbell.com. You can get one of my books on there. If you don't know how to read or you don't have $10, that's not a problem. There's a link to my podcast. You can just go watch or listen to my podcast. That is 100% free. That's not enough for you though.
Like I said, there's the books, or you can hire a coach or get a consultation. And there's also links to purchase pre-workouts, exercise equipment, absolutely anything that you need to be successful on your journey. You can find at www.davenportbarbell.com.
Oh, hey, Dan Bell here. As many of you guys know, I'm a world's strongest powerlifter. I actually just finished up reading this book from Scott Davenport's Mixed Martial Arts. I love how he gets in the mindset grit required to become successful. Scott tells a story of how it was installed in him in his early years. He then takes you through his rise through fighting, the camps, the coaches, his influences, and his opponents. He also dives into the hardships, the challenges, and injuries, everything that he needed to overcome. Scott's virtues and faith carried him through these hardships and challenges to find your own. That mindset and that lessons that Scott learned and expressed in this book can be transferred to almost any endeavor. If you're interested in this story and how hard work, perseverance, faith can carry a person to their goals, this book is definitely for you.